Sam here from Creative Minds. In this video, we're going to explore some of the advanced features available with the CM Answers plugin from Creative Minds. Some of these features include custom CSS, short codes, a rich text editor, social media login, among others. So let's get started.
On your dashboard, if you go down to your CM Answers tab and you go to Logs, here you can find a logs table with stats of all your posted questions, answers, and votes on questions and answers. You can see the time that it was posted, the user who posted, their email address, IP address, and also there's a geolocator so you can see where that person is from. You can also view this information in graphic form, and you can filter by week, month, or year so that you can see this information in the most useful way for you to analyze it. So let's take a look at posted questions. It shows you a log of everyone who has posted questions within a year. If we go to votes on answers, just to show you again that you can filter by month, and then you can see the times of highest activity on your site. Now, to get that feature where you can see the country of the user who's posted, on your general settings, you'll need to put in an API key, and you can get this from InfoDB. You can just register for a free account, enter all of your information, and you're good to go. If you go to Disclaimer, you can see that you can add a disclaimer to appear when a user first encounters the question and answer forum, and you can choose the text of this disclaimer, and also the text of the accept and reject buttons. Under custom CSS in your settings, you can see the default custom CSS, and then you can also see there are various options for style modifications to determine exactly how that question and answer form is going to appear. For example, let's do the best answer icon size. So we're gonna add this to the CSS, and here we're gonna customize the font size, and let's make this a large icon, so we're gonna put 30. And then let's also choose question font size. So we can go ahead and change this to a size 20 font. And after you've put that in, if you go ahead and update that custom CSS, we go to this post page, and as you can see, the question font appears in size 20. And if we scroll down to the question that was marked as the best answer, you can see that the icon appears here very large in a size 30 font. Under the Appearance tab in your settings, if you scroll down to Editor, here's where you can enable the rich text editor so that when people post a question or answer, they see a rich text editor and they can easily bold, italicize, add links, add media, etc. So let's just put in sample answer, and you can see how easy it is for someone to just go in there and edit that text with the rich text editor. And if we post this answer, you can see it shows up with the edits right in your answer. And just a reminder that you can vote on answers. You can also mark answers as the best answer. And on your settings page, this is where you can find some really useful shortcodes that allow you to embed your question and answer forum. The CMA My Questions and My Answers makes it so that the user who is logged in sees their questions and answers. And then the CMA Questions shortcode shows all questions on your site. And if you show the additional parameters, you can see that there are various options. A very useful one is Category. This is a very easy way to have multiple forums on your site defined by category. There's also a search parameter, which can add a search form on your question and answer forum. So now if we go into a post and we're gonna put in our custom short code, CMA questions, category food, we're gonna put in a question form at the end, and we're gonna get rid of those views. So if you preview those changes, you can see directly in this post, we have all questions under the category of food. And there's also a question form that people can fill out to add their own question. And I did the same thing for film. So as you can see, you can put different categories of forums on different pages on your site. Another example, if we put in my questions on this post, summer recipes, we're going to add the search parameter. So this is going to add a search bar to that question and answer form. So here people can search the questions. And there's also a list of all of my questions that I have authored. Under the social logins tab in your settings, you can hook up your question and answers form with various social media sites, including Facebook. So for example, for Facebook, you're going to follow this link and create a new app directly in Facebook. You're going to put in a display name, choose a category, and then create that app. Then you're going to choose website as the app platform. And then you're just going to take the URL of your site and put that into the Facebook app as a site URL, save changes. Then you'll be given an app ID and an app secret. And then you're going to go back to your dashboard and just fill these in. So after you've put in your app ID and secret, you can update. So as you can see on this question and answer forum page at the bottom, a user can simply log in through their Facebook account.